Hello everyone, welcome to ClearTax GST Academy. My name is Megha and I'm working at ClearTax as a GST product expert. Today, I will walk you through the various modes you can prepare your GSTR1 and file your return using the fastest and easiest way. First mode is if you are using Tally ERP software or Busy software. Second is if you are using Government GSTR1 offline utility. Third is if you have created your bills using ClearTax billing feature. And fourth is if you are using any other accounting software. If you are not a registered user, sign up today. Go to gst.cleartax.in. If you are already a registered user, log into your account using your login credentials.
If you want to create your sales bill using ClearTax GST software billing feature and file the return, please continue watching the video. Creating bills on ClearTax GST software is super easy and it gives you 100% GST compliant bills every time. And did you know? Billing feature is 100% free on ClearTax GST software. That is, you don't need to pay any subscription fee for creating bills on the software. Log in to ClearTax GST software using your login credentials. On your dashboard, select the GSTN you want to work on. Now click on GST Return. Now on the GSTN dashboard, click on File GSTR1 Now. Under tab 1, read the quick guide. Now click on Start Filing GSTR1. The first step in GSTR1 filing is preparing your data. To create bills using the software, click on Create Invoices. Now enter the required fields and click on Save Invoice. You can create or view your sales invoices. To create a new sales document, click on Create Sales Document. Now select the type of sales document you want to create. For example, credit or debit note, you will see that your data is automatically appearing here. That is, the software has prepared the return in line with the data updated by you in form of invoice. If you are using any other billing solution or digital book or a paper bill book, you can use ClearTax easy to use Excel templates. To use the Excel template, go to Upload Excel under tab 2. You will be taken to Import Invoices screen. Here, you will see three steps. In these three simple steps, you can import all your sales and purchase data into ClearTax. For filing GSTR1, you need to import your sales data. Step 1. Download the template from the drop-down below for the kind of entries you want to upload. For example, sales invoice and bill of supply. Select the template and click on download sample. You'll see an Excel file has been downloaded. Look at each sheet of the Excel file. Here you'll find all the steps that you need to follow to successfully import all your data. Fill the spreadsheet with all the required data and then save the file. Step 3. Here, you need to specify the template that you want to upload. Browse the file and click on Open. If there is any error in the data, the same will be highlighted. Click on Fix to correct the errors. Read the error message, take required action and then click on Revalidate. Now come back and click on Go to GSTN Dashboard. Now click on File GSTR1 Now. Under tab 2, you will see that once data has been prepared or imported, the software automatically reads it and prepares GST return form in line with government format. Please note, if you are using ClearTax GST billing software or have imported your data using ClearTax Excel template, you will have to enter the data manually in the other details, that is summary level section. To enter the data, click on View or Edit. Now move down to Summary of Documents and Summary of HSN of each item sold. Click on Edit or View to review the data. Click on Add New Row to add details. Now enter the turnover details and click on Update Turnover Details. You'll be taken to Upload Summary tab. Please note, when you upload your invoices and HSN and document series summary to government portal, the government validates your data for error. In case of errors, it gives you a JSON file highlighting all the errors. ClearTax will enable you to make your data error-free by fetching the government report. You need to click on Validate Data Before Upload button and your data will be validated and a JSON file will start getting downloaded. Open the file and simultaneously click on View My Invoices. Make changes in the required invoices and save the changes. Now come back and click on Upload to GSTN. Before you can upload your invoices to GSTN, you need to allow API access to ClearTax. Let's see how it's done. Step 1. Enable access to GSTN portal. Read our quick guide and follow the steps. Log in with GST portal using your username and password. After login, click on View Profile on Dashboard. Click on Manage API Access from Quick Links. Change Enable API Access to Yes. Select duration as 30 days and click on Confirm. Finish. Now you can come back to ClearTax. Under step 2, just enter your username and click on Authorize Now. Now you'll see number of documents uploaded as well as history of documents uploaded with the status of upload. Now let's move to the final step, file return. Under tab 5, you'll see that multiple steps to file GSTR1 have been listed. The step 1 is review uploaded data. Once you have uploaded your data to GSTN, you need to download GSTR1 report from the government portal. Review the data in the report to make sure that all invoices have been correctly uploaded to GSTN. You can also take print of the summary. Next, click on Continue Filing. You'll see that as you submit the report, your data is frozen, which means you can't make any further changes. Click on Proceed to Next Step. Now you need to select the mode of e-verification. You can sign using Aadhaar-based mobile OTP or using a digital signature. Please note, for now, you can sign your return using only DSC on ClearTax platform. Select digital signature and enter the PAN. And now click on File GSTR1. As you can see, your GSTR1 is submitted and the ARN number has been made available for your reference. We will learn how you can file your GSTR1 if you are using Tally ERP as your accounting software and recording your sales and purchase bills on Tally and want to file your GST returns in the fastest and easiest way, continue watching the video. On Tally, if you have recorded your sales data, you can export it as an Excel file and then import it into ClearTax. ClearTax will read the data and prepare the return form for you. Let's see how it is done. Step 1. Exporting GSTR1 from Tally. Login to Tally and select your company name. Go to Gateway of Tally and under Reports, click on Display. On the Display menu, click on Statutory Reports and then click on GST. Now select GSTR1 to export all your output supplies data, that is sales data, from your Tally. You'll be taken to GSTR1 screen. Review the summary and click on E-Returns on the right sidebar to export the data. Now choose Excel option to save the file as an Excel file. To start filing your return, log in to ClearTax GST software using your login credentials. On your dashboard, select the GSTN you want to work on. Now click on GST Return. Now on the GSTN dashboard, click on File GSTR1 Now. Under tab 1, read the quick guide. Now click on Start Filing GSTR1. The first step in GSTR1 filing is preparing your data. As you have already saved your Tally data, you need to just import it into ClearTax. To import the data, click on Upload Tally or Business. Select the applicable sheets that you want to upload. Now click on Choose File from your computer. Browse the file and click on Open. Your file will start getting uploaded. If there is any error in the data, the same will be highlighted. Click on Fix to correct the errors. Read the error message, take required action, and then click on Revalidate. Now come back and click on Go to GSTN Dashboard. Now click on File GSTR1 Now. Under tab 2, you will see that once data has been prepared or imported, the software automatically reads it and prepares GST return form in line with government format. Now look at different sections of your GST return. Section 1 is Details of Outward Supplies by Taxpayer. Click on Edit or View to review the data. Now move down to Summary of Documents and Summary of HSN of each item sold. Click on Edit or View to review the data. Click on Add New Row to add details. Now enter the turnover details and click on Update Turnover Details. You'll be taken to Upload Summary tab. Please note, when you upload your invoices and HSN and document series summary to government portal, the government validates your data for error. In case of errors, it gives you a JSON file highlighting all the errors. ClearTax will enable you to make your data error-free by fetching the government report. You need to click on Validate Data Before Upload button and your data will be validated and a JSON file will start getting downloaded. Open the file and simultaneously click on View My Invoices. Make changes in the required invoices and save the changes. Now come back and click on Upload to GSTN. Before you can upload your invoices to GSTN, you need to allow API access to ClearTax. Let's see how it's done. Step 1. Enable access to GSTN portal. Read our quick guide and follow the steps. Login with GST portal using your username and password. After login, click on View Profile on Dashboard. Click on Manage API Access from Quick Links. Change Enable API Access to Yes. Select Duration as 30 days and click on Confirm. Finished. Now you can come back to ClearTax. Under Step 2, just enter your username and click on Authorize Now. Now you'll see number of documents uploaded as well as history of documents uploaded with the status of upload. Now let's move to the final step, file return. Under tab 5, you'll see that multiple steps to file GSTR1 have been listed. The step 1 is review uploaded data. Once you have uploaded your data to GSTN, you need to download GSTR1 report from the government portal. Review the data in the report to make sure that all invoices have been correctly uploaded to GSTN. You can also take print of the summary. Next, click on Continue Filing. You'll see that as you submit the report, your data is frozen, which means you can't make any further changes. Click on Proceed to Next Step. Now you need to select the mode of e-verification. You can sign using Aadhaar-based mobile OTP or using a digital signature. Please note, for now, you can sign your return using only DSC on ClearTax platform. Select digital signature and enter the PAN. And now click on File GSTR1. As you can see, your GSTR1 is submitted and the ARN number has been made available for your reference.
We will learn how you can file your GSTR1 if you have prepared your outward supplies or sales data using government GSTR1 offline utility. Continue watching the video. The government released its offline utility for GSTR1, which is basically an Excel sheet in which taxpayers can record their outward supplies. If you want to use government GSTR1 offline utility, follow the steps. Go to www.gst.gov.in. Now click on Downloads. Then click on Offline Tools. Select Returns Offline Tool. Under Returns Offline Tool version V1.2.1, click on Download button. You'll see a zipped file has been downloaded named as GST Offline Tool. Open the folder and click on GSTR1 Excel Workbook Template. Fill the template with required information for the tax period and save the file. Filing GSTR1 on ClearTax is majorly a 3-step process. Step 1. Prepare your outward supplies data and review the data. Step 2. Upload invoices to GSTN. Step 3. File the return. Simple, isn't it? Login to ClearTax GST software using your login credentials. On your dashboard, select the GSTN for which you want to file the return. Now click on GST Returns. Now, on the GSTN dashboard, click on File GSTR1 Now. Under tab 1, read the quick guide. Now click on Start Filing GSTR1. The first step in GSTR1 filing is preparing your data. If you are using government utility template, click on Tally or Busy. Select the applicable sheets that you want to upload.
Now click on Choose File from your computer. Browse the file and click on Open. Your file will start getting uploaded. If there is any error in the data, the same will be highlighted. Click on Fix to correct the errors. Read the error message, take required action, and then click on Revalidate. Now come back and click on Go to GSTN Dashboard. Now click on File GSTR1 Now. Under tab 2, you will see that once data has been prepared or imported, the software automatically reads it and prepares GST return form in line with government format. Now look at different sections of your GST return. Section 1 is Details of Outward Supplies by Taxpayer. Click on Edit or View to review the data.
Now move down to summary of documents and summary of HSN of each item sold. Click on edit a view to review the data. Click on add new row to add details. Now enter the turnover details and click on update turnover details. You'll be taken to upload summary tab. Please note, when you upload your invoices and HSN and document series summary to government portal, the government validates your data for error. In case of errors, it gives you a JSON file highlighting all the errors. ClearTax will enable you to make your data error-free by fetching the government report. You need to click on Validate Data Before Upload button and your data will be validated and a JSON file will start getting downloaded. Open the file and simultaneously click on View My Invoices. Make changes in the required invoices and save the changes. Now come back and click on Upload to GSTN. Before you can upload your invoices to GSTN, you need to allow API access to ClearTax. Let's see how it's done. Step 1. Enable access to GSTN portal. Read our quick guide and follow the steps. Login with GST portal using your username and password. After login, click on View Profile on Dashboard. Click on Manage API Access from Quick Links. Change Enable API Access to Yes. Select Duration as 30 days and click on Confirm. Finished. Now you can come back to ClearTax. Under Step 2, just enter your username and click on Authorize Now. Now you'll see number of documents uploaded as well as history of documents uploaded with the status of upload. Now let's move to the final step, file return. Under tab 5, you'll see that multiple steps to file GSTR1 have been listed. The step 1 is review uploaded data. Once you have uploaded your data to GSTN, you need to download GSTR1 report from the government portal. Review the data in the report to make sure that all invoices have been correctly uploaded to GSTN. You can also take print of the summary. Next, click on Continue Filing. You'll see that as you submit the report, your data is frozen, which means you can't make any further changes. Click on Proceed to Next Step. Now you need to select the mode of e-verification. You can sign using Aadhaar-based mobile OTP or using a digital signature. Please note, for now, you can sign your return using only DSC on ClearTax platform. Select digital signature and enter the PAN. And now click on File GSTR1. As you can see, your GSTR1 is submitted and the ARN number has been made available for your reference. Thank you for watching the video.